Somebody say, at the end. said, this is the end. So at the end, it shall speak. And not that. Look at your neighbor and say, God keeps his promises. So I'm standing on the promises of God. Amen. You may be seated. I want to deal with the fact because we're now living in a world that seems to be so impacted by what men think. There was a time when we did not care what anybody thought. If God said it was all right, we didn't care about the other crowd because we were not politically correct. We did not wonder, amen, about what somebody else thought. We did not care about their approach to certain things. But the awesome thing is that whatever God said, we took that thing to heart. Abraham was such a person because Abraham, amen, left father and grandfather according to the word of God. And the Bible said he went he was going. Yeah. The awesome thing about it is sometimes God will give you a mission and a commission so that you know that God has called you and nobody else. When somebody said nobody else.
Nobody else.
The awesome thing about it is that when God calls you, you have a divine assurance. When God calls you, nobody can change your mind. When God calls you, nobody can persuade you different. When God calls you, your mind's already made up. Already fixed. And so therefore you got a word from God. Look at your neighbor and say, I got a promise.
I got a promise
from God.
From God.
And so there have been so many down through the years that have stood on the promises of God. When God told the world, Noah that the world was going to end and he was going to flood this world by water, Noah believed God and the promises of God came to Noah. Destroy the whole world. The Bible said, but Noah found grace. Yes. Somebody said, Noah found grace.
Noah found grace.
In the eyes of the Lord.
Yes.
Before there was a when or where, how, now, period of semicolon, God had already promised, amen, that he was going to get somebody. And so God had already chose Noah before he ever came forth.
Yes.
Amen. And Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Yes.
He was supposed to die, but he found grace. So Noah was standing on the promise of God. Methuselah was standing on the promise of God. Amen. Enoch, who was Methuselah's daddy, who lived to be, amen, 965. And Methuselah lived to be 969. Because his name meant when he is dead, the flood is coming. Amen. So therefore, we find that God keeps his promises. When God said he was going to destroy the world by water, he meant it. But he said the next time is going to be by fire.
Yeah.
So therefore, God keeps his promises.
Yeah.
And though the world be removed out from under our feet, God keeps his promises.
Yeah.
Though the heavens and the earth shall pass away, God keeps his promises.
Yeah.
Though, amen, men and women shall backslide on God, go away from God, turn their backs on God. Somebody's going to hang on their robe and put them in the closet. Amen, on the church pew. Somebody, amen, is going to say, I won't preach another word. Somebody is going to say, I never sing another song. But look at your neighbor and say,
God
is a promise keeper. Amen. God will help you to keep your promise. You got to learn to stand on the promises of God. No matter what's going on, if your wife decides she's going to walk out the door, you got to stand on the promise. If your children decide, I'll never call you again, you got to stand on the promise. When folks start acting funny and your money gets funny, amen, and your life get all mixed up and messed up, look at your neighbor and say, I'm standing on the promises of God. God promised Abraham, said, if you follow me, I'll make you great. If you follow me, I'll make your name great. I'll make you like the sands of the sea. Amen. The stars of the heaven like the sands of the sea and the dust of the earth. And I was walking the other day, amen, about a grain of sand. And I said, some people may feel like a grain of sand. I said, well, God. Yeah. couldn't go in the furnace. I wouldn't bow down. He threw it in the furnace. But it didn't burn. The only thing burned in the furnace is that they had a weapon. And so I had to praise me down in the furnace. Imagine when they got in there and saw Jesus. Somebody probably started praising. Did not throw three men in. He said, I see four. Tell somebody, say, amen. There's somebody. Yes, with me. Because they throw that to them and said, look, our God who we serve is able. Somebody say, thank you.
Every day I win. Ooh, every day I've got the victory. Every day. Won't you help me say?
Every day I win.
Oh.